Dr. Kalam, our guru, is the guru for the entire defense scientists of the country. After he joining DRDO, he brought in a total change in the perspective of DRDO. Firstly, he brought in the program, Integrated Guided Missiles Development Program, developing 5 missiles simultaneously, the Prithvi, Agni, Akash, Trishul and Nag. And today, we have all these missiles inducted into the armed forces, the Prithvi, the Dhanush, Agni 1, 2, 3, 4, Agni 5, the Brahmos, the supersonic cruise missile, the Indo-Russian joint venture, which was the dream of Dr. Kalam to have India developed a unique missile in the world. He's the one who has created the research center Imarat, one of the most advanced defense research and development laboratories. He's the one who has established the test range for the missiles at Chandipur, Balasur, Orissa. And it is his period who has brought in the light combat aircraft Tejas, which is being inducted into the Air Force in a larger number, the Arjun tank, and many technologies which has brought in. On the other side, tried to help the humankind with a lot of medical devices being developed. As Director DRDL and RCI, he worked with the NIMS Hospital in Hyderabad and developed the Kalam Raju stunt with Dr. Somaraju. So many things. His thinking has been always big, as what he has well been saying so. Brought in major programs, and today the indigenous content in the armed forces is so high, it is out of the initiatives what have been taken by Dr. Kalam. He told me one thing when I took over as Director RCI, Satish, you just think what I should be remembered for as Director RCI. And then that you define and work for it. When I became the scientific advisor to Raksha Mantri, and when I went to meet him, I spent about more than 2 hours in 10 Rajaji Mark and give me so much of guidance and asked me to work on reusable missile. This is the way his thinking has always been, and he has always looked for the progress of the country, utilizing the technologies for the humankind, and his vision today DRDO is trying to spearhead and try to make advanced indigenous weapons for the armed forces of the country, making the country self-reliant, and also try to export these arms and weapons to the entire world by making India a prosperous country. I said 2-3